So good morning student and welcome to the quality improvement in math education project. So we are delivering some lecture with reference to linear equation. So this is quality improvement in math education video based PPT presentation 2019. So today's topic is linear equation. I am Dhananjay Vasantrao Joshi. My registration number is MTF027 027, and my school name is Sri Saraswati Bhuvan High School, Aurangabad, and I am from Aurangabad district. So today going to deliver this lecture, we just observe the things, think behind that and just observe here. So look at the picture and compare them. So you see the picture here, the two men are standing, the left side man and the right side man. So look at the height. We assume the variable, the height of the left side man as A and the variable B to the height of the right side man. Now you just compare the heights regarding the variables A and B. What you find here, A is greater than B, that means the height of left side man is greater than the height of right side man. So comparison is very important in reference to equation. Now look at the second picture. What you find here? There are fish inside the fish tanks. Now you just look at the fish tank. Don't look the fish inside the fish tank. So we assume the variable X as left side fish tank and variable Y as right side fish tank. Now compare the fish tank. What you find here? The left side fish tank is smaller than right side fish tank. It means that X is less than Y. So comparison is very important factor and we assume with reference to the variable. Now look at this video and think what the video is going to say.
A scale with me in which I put two points to the left side and one point to the right side. Now look at the scale, it is in balance. To balance the scale, I must need to put a coin to the right side. Now look at the scale, it is balance. When there is a balance of scale, we put equal sign at the middle. Now look here, right hand side is equal to left hand side. If there is an equality, we call it as equation. Now I add two coins to the left side. Look at again, there is an imbalance. For balancing, I must add two coins to the right side. Now there is a balance in a scale. Now I remove two coins from the right side. Again there is an imbalance. To balance it, I must remove two coins from the left side. Now there is a balance. I have put an unknown quantity to the left of the pan and same unknown quantity to the right of the pan. So in mathematics, the unknown quantity is represented by any variable. Now I just name as X to the unknown quantity and same name as X to that unknown quantity. Now there is a balance because both quantities are same, represented by x. Now I put the unknown quantity from right side and put to the left side. Now there is a imbalance of equation, that means the scale is not balanced. So x and x, it become 2x. So balancing this, I must repeat the procedure again. I just put one unknown quantity from left and put to the right. Now it become x and x. The scale is balanced. Now I just open it and to find what actually inside. There are three coins. Again, we find here there are three coins here. So left side and right side become equal. That means there is an equality. An equality is called as equation.
So the balancing means the equality. Well, in an expression there are two sides and if they are equal, then it is called as equation. Okay, so now we have some equations. Look at that equation and state the degree of the equation. What is the meaning of degree? Degree is the highest power of an equation. So look at the first equation. Here is x square plus 7x plus 5 is equal to 0. Now tell me, what is the degree here? What is the highest power? It is 2. That means the degree of the equation is 2. Take another example. 6x cube plus 9x square plus 8x plus 3 is equal to 0. So degree is the highest power, that is 3. Again take one equation. 7x plus 8 is equal to 29. Now the degree here is 1 because the highest power is 1. Another example I just put in front of you. 13x cube plus 5x square plus 3 is equal to 0. Now here the degree is 3. Take another one. 9x square plus 8x plus 3 is equal to 0. Here is the degree is 2. So I just take another example. 8x plus 7y is equal to 17. Here two variables are there, but the degree is 1. So can you think something about that? The highest power is degree. So we are having some equation with degree 3, some are having degree 2, and some are having degree 1. Now, students, I have some flashcards and just give to the 10 students the flashcard containing the equation. So make some convenient group as your wish and see what the student do.
Good morning, student. Your friend Akshay have some card with him. He just give one card to the each student. So Akshay, please give one card to each student. Akshay, give it. Take one card from Akshay. Look at it carefully. Discuss among you and form a group as you deem fit. I think Akshay deliver the card. Just discuss among you. Concentrate on what you are giving. Hope all you have get a card. Now all you need to do is to form a group on your own. Are they not completed still? Can you complete your group? I hope everybody can complete it. So I think I am starting from this side. Now my question goes to group 1. This is your group you are forming. Second group I think you are counting from here, and middle is the third group. Okay. So my question goes to group number 1. By which property is the group formed? Can you show your card, please? Okay, so degree of equation is 3. Very nice, good. I just concentrate on group 2. So group 2, now it is your turn. What about your group? Very nice. Please show your cards. Yes. Can you read your equation? Yes, you. Can you read it? Very nice. Aditya. Very nice. And the last group which is remaining, what is your observation of your group that you are formed? Okay, can you show your card, please? Yes. So, read what you are having. Very nice. Very nice. Very good. Very nice. So, everybody now form a group. My left side, cubic equation is there. The degree is 3. My right side, quadratic equation is there, the degree is 2, and the middle one having degree 1, that is called linear equation. So I just concentrate on group 3, that is middle group. Can you form any some extra group among you? You just discuss first, and just can you able to form any other group? Are you form some extra group? Actually, very nice. What is the meaning of linear equation in one variable? Very nice. And what is the meaning of linear equation in two variables? Very nice. So today's activity, what are the findings? Basically, the equation and the degree were related to each other. If the degree of equation is 3, that is called as, very nice. If the degree of equation is 2, that is called as, and the middle one, if the degree of equation is 1, that is called as. So what is our finding is that there are cubic equation having degree 3, quadratic equation having degree 2, and linear equation having degree. And in the linear equation, if one variable is present, it is called linear equation in one variable. And if two variables are present, it is called as. So, I just have some little bit extra point. If there is a graph in which a straight line is formed, that is also called as linear equation. So the graph of linear equation is always straight line. Okay, thank you, students.
So we just go with our next phase, that is define and prove. So using the concept, so we are going to define what we learn in observe and explore. So first is equation. When two expressions are equal, then we call them as equation. We are going to deal with some linear equation in that video. So what is linear equation? When in any equation, degree of variable is 1, then it is a linear equation. Simultaneous equation means what? When we consider two linear equation in two variables simultaneously and we get a unique common solution, then such set of equation are known as simultaneous linear equations. There are some methods of solving linear equation in two variable. First is of method of elimination by equating coefficients. Second method is method of elimination by substitution. Third one is by Cramer's rule. We are finding the solution by Cramer's rule. This is also called as the determinant method. And the next is of graphical method. So today we are going to deal with the graphical method. We are having two equations, x plus y is equal to 6 and x minus y is equal to 4. So what is the flow chart to find the solution? Convert that equation in y. So our equation, first equation become y is equal to 6 minus x, and second equation become y is equal to x minus 4. So take any three values of x and find the corresponding values of y. Taking the coordinate x, y and plot them on coordinate axis and join them to form a line. So we are finding the points here. So our first equation is x plus y is equal to 6 and second equation is x minus y is equal to 4. So we are converting first equation as y is equal to 6 minus x. We are finding the values of y. So first we take x is equal to 4, the value y is equal to 2. If you take x is equal to minus 1, the value of y become 7. If you take x is equal to 0, the value of y become 6. So our coordinates x, y are 4, 2, minus 1, 7 and 0, 6. We are taking the equation y is equal to x minus 4. So we are taking first value x is equal to 1. We are finding y is equal to minus 3. Taking x is equal to minus 2, y is equal to minus 6. Taking x is equal to 0, y becomes minus 4. So our coordinate for this equation are 1, minus 3, minus 2, minus 6 and 0, 4. So plot all points on graph. Join all points to make a line. Find the point of intersection of line which is the solution of given line. Now we are draw the graph by using GeoGebra. So we are plotting the points what you derived. So our first point is 4, 2. Second point is minus 1, 7 and third point is 0, 6. We are joining all these three points named as ABC. We get a line of equation x plus y is equal to 6. So our next equation is x minus y is equal to 4. Our first point is 1, 5. So we are plotting that point. So 1, minus 3. Our next point is what we going to derive here is minus 2, minus 6 and our third point is 0, minus 4. We just join all these three points named as D, E, F of the equation x minus y is equal to 4. We are getting G as the intersection of two lines and this is our solution of given line. So the points of G is 5, 1. So this is the solution of line x plus y is equal to 6 and line x minus y is equal to 4. We are going into our next phase, that is apply and evaluate. It is getting to the concept. What we learn up till, we are having some application of that. Now we are having some problem here. So just go through that problem and solve by all three methods. So my first problem is, in two digit numbers, the unit digit is thrice the 10 digit. If 36 is added to the number, the digit interchange their places. Find the numbers. If next is, if 2 is added to the numerator and denominator, it becomes 9 by 10. And if 3 is subtracted from numerator and denominator, it becomes 4 by 5. Find the fractions. Next equation is, army traveled 300 km by train and 200 km by bus. It took him 5 hours and 30 minutes. But if they traveled 260 km by train and 240 km by bus, they take 6 minutes longer than previous one. So find the speed of the train and bus. This is what the applications of linear equations. So we are having some slider, some additional application of GeoGebra. We are creating the slider, that is slider 1. We are creating the slider 2. Yes, so creating of slider 1 is here. By using the slider, we are changing the values of the x and y. So slider 1 is there, slider bm is equal to 1, slider b1 is equal to 1. We are again take another two sliders. So we are creating the line here. So y is equal to mx plus c. So this line we are creating. We are creating another two sliders for next two lines. So another sliders are created. So we are creating another lines and changing the values to get more lines and more solution. This is the application of GeoGebra. So we create two sliders for line first and two sliders for line 2. So by this way, we are going to deal with two lines and some more two solutions are there. So using that, you are creating much more line as you want and finding the much more solutions what you are having. So this is what we are going to deal with linear equation by graphical method, and we are using here by, we are changing the values here. So this is